بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. This is Hussein Musa, lecturer in economics and head of the commerce department from Government Degree Boys College, Baldia Town, Sector 4E. So I have the privilege to present here the paper pattern for the principles of economics for first year commerce, regular and private. Now, it's very easy to understand this pattern. As you know, the principle of economics for first year commerce is for total 75 marks. And these 75 marks is divided into section A, section B, and section C. So let's see each section one by one. Section A belongs to the MCQs, multiple choice questions. MCQs, and section A includes question 1 only, and there will be 15 questions in this question number 1, subsections of this question number 1, and each question or each MCQ is for 1 mark. So there are total 15 marks for this section A or question number 1. And the allocated time, the maximum time, is for 20 minutes. Now, let's see the other part of the paper. Now, two sections are remaining. Section B, we have short answer questions in section B. And we have two questions, question 2 and 3. Actually, the whole syllabus is divided into two parts, microeconomics and macroeconomics. So question number 2 focuses the microeconomics only, and there will be 7 questions given, from which 5 questions have to be attempted, and each question is for 4 marks. So the total 20 marks is allocated for question number 2 in microeconomics. In the same fashion, we have question number 3, but this is for macroeconomics. Again, 7 questions will be given, from which we have to attempt 5 questions and 4 marks for each question, so 20 marks. So 20 plus 20, 40 marks is allocated for this section B, and these questions are short answer questions. So answer should be very short, to the point, very brief, and it must contain, you know, the content which is asked. Question, now let's see the section C. We have, as it is named, detailed answer questions. Again, there are 2 questions. One question is covering microeconomics, question number 4, and question number 5 is covering macroeconomics. Now in each question number 4 or 5, 2 questions are given, from which we have to attempt only 1 question, and this 1 question is for 10 marks. So if you add all the marks for section from section B and section C, there will be total 60 marks, and total time for this part of the paper is 2 hours 40 minutes. So 20 minutes were given to the MCQs and 2 hours 40 minutes given to this part of the paper. So the total time for this paper is 3 hours. Let's see the further example. I have taken the picture of Principle of Economics, paper 1 from the annual examination of 2019 last year, which happened on 30th April 2019. You can see that the name of the paper is given, and so commerce, regular and private. The date is mentioned here. So let's see, as from the pointer, I'm going to see here the time, and starting from 2 p.m. to 2:20 p.m. That means this is the time total of 20 minutes, 50 marks, section A, MCQs only. Remember, students, you always have to read the instructions very carefully. So some instructions are given in the answer sheet, and some instructions are given in the question paper. You also have instructions given in your admit card. So instructions are written, and they are written for you, so that you can read them and understand them, so that you can act upon them. Very easy. You can see section of note 1, that section, this section consists of 15 part questions, and all are to be answered. Each question carries 1 mark. Do not copy the part questions in answer script. Write only answer in full against the proper number of the question and its part. And in 3, write the code of your question paper in bold letters in the beginning of answer script. This is the example. For example, section A, question number 1, subsection 1. Like choose the correct answer from each question given below. So this is question number 1. Section 1. In perfect competition, average revenue and marginal revenue curves are shaped horizontally. This is the right answer. So we have to write the whole answer like this. And similarly, in question number 2, the correct answer is transfer payments, because transfer payments is not included in the national income. The transfer payments are written like this. So you can see, remember, you have to write the code on the top of the paper, so that when an examiner checks your paper, he checks it with the answer given according to the code. So, because these questions are rearranged for every code, or you can say jumbled for every code, so that you have to write the code, it will be easy for his examiner to check and to avoid the mistakes. Let's see this short answer questions. The section B is actually for short answer questions. You can see here, this is the remaining time given, duration 2:20 to 5 p.m. 2 hours 40 minutes, and total time for this paper 60 marks. Section B, you can see it is named short answer questions. This is for 40 marks total, and this section B is divided further into two parts, microeconomics and macroeconomics. I have not mentioned macroeconomics because here microeconomics and macroeconomics are given in the same fashion. So you can see there are 7 parts in question number 2. Attempt any 5 of the following part questions. And the total marks for question 2 is 20. So obviously each question will be for 4 marks. It's not important to do them in order. You just have to mention the question number and subsection number and answer the question. But you have to state the reference question, I mean question number and the subsection, very carefully, again, so that it can be easily checked or assessed. So I have not mentioned microeconomics because it is in the same fashion. 20 marks is given for microeconomics and 20 for macroeconomics in question number 3. So let's see the section C. Section C, so detailed answer questions, and 20 marks are allocated for this section C. As you can see, the microeconomics 10 marks and macroeconomics 10 marks. And 2 questions are given in question number 4 and question number 5, as it was stated earlier. And you have to attempt any one question, any one of the following parts. So I hope you have understood.